complexity of running your infrastructure. So that is one layer less. You do not need to look at the hypervisor anymore. So that's pretty nice. And you see the variety of OSs that we support. So we support Google, True, Red Hat, SUSE. On some of them, we will support Google, right? That's also something which is going on. So this is just an illustration of the variety of workloads that could be served by such an infrastructure. And we will have solutions for all these types of workloads. So what is in green here, if you look at the green parts, which are here, 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 we can serve that today. We are announcing a set of new cartridges here in 2013, where all the blue type of applications will be serverless. So this is now available with specific cartridges. So we can do, you see the type of workloads that we can serve. If you are a banker, we can do Monte Carlo simulation, exchange jobs. If you do drugs, discovery, or that kind of thing, health and lifestyle. If you are in energy, so that's oil and gas, we will have a specific cartridge. The beauty about that is that HP delivers cartridges that we think are useful. But if you think you have a need, we can develop a cartridge for you. The development cycles and the number of units is very low. So that means that we can guarantee that we can deliver a cartridge that is specific to your needs in 3 months and for a very limited budget. So we are doing that already for several customers, including oil and gas customers. So we deliver now customer-defined servers. Isn't that amazing? This is something which is, again, a radical change in looking at your environment. If you are an industrial and know that you are running one main application, it just makes sense. Because it will save you so much power, it will save you so much burden on running that application on a traditional infrastructure. So that's the type of thing that we think is going to take over. So I'm not saying that everyone will benefit. For the time being, it is with rather simple applications or trivial requirements. But again, very soon we are going to see the Haswell version of the cartridge. And Haswell is perfect for this. The Haswell low power will come out on this cartridge and can be used. So 45 Haswell cartridges on a single box. Can you imagine that? I mean, that's amazing. And the costs obviously are pretty significantly lower than the traditional infrastructure. Any questions, comments? But I'm enthusiastic about Moonshot because I really think that this is, it changes the paradigm, it changes the way that you can look at HPC, yet again, because it is something that is now driven by the software. So you think of your software architecture, and we provide you the infrastructure, the hardware that serves this application at the desk, and for very limited power usage. So we are developing all those cartridges as we see. So we have announced 5 new cartridges, and very soon we are going to have another set of 6 cartridges. All of them being developed with our partners, whether it be Intel, whether it be ARM, whether it be NVIDIA. So we're going to have graphic cards, we're going to have digital signal processing, we are going to have encryption, description, all those type of work will be available. Sorry, do I speak too fast? Still okay? Okay, thank you. So our partners are multiple. For Moonshot, it is not a simple thing. So we must work with a lot of partners to make sure that they are in this game of adapting their software or taking our hardware to run their software. So we have a lot of partners, including ISV, obviously, but obviously hardware vendors are also there. What we can do for you is also to use these services. So we have what we call the Discovery Lab, and this is a very simple mechanism. If you think you want to test that environment or do a proof of concept, we can host you. So that means that you do that either in our labs or we do that remotely. You come with your problem and we help you demonstrate the value of this infrastructure. So this is something which is very straightforward. We deliver that, we deliver many of those discovery lab sessions. And this is something that you just contact HP and we put you in contact with the HP Discovery Lab, which is in Europe. Okay? And this is very simple and straightforward. Okay? No cost, and we guarantee that you will be helped and supported by this team. So that's very simple to get something. Let me now come to the other end of the chain. So we now have seen the storage, SL4500. We have seen the day-to-day workforce SL6500. We have seen the low end, which is moonshot, low power. Now let's go to the high end system. And here this is something, I'm just giving you a preview, which is not yet launched, but this system is already being used by some customers. So we have delivered. What is this beast? I told you when I introduced Apollo that this is in a single rack as much as 144 servers. Okay. So that's very high density. This is a water-cooled system. So that means that in the middle here, between the servers, you have a water wall that provides cool water up to the edge of the server. Or off the edge of the surface, that we are swimming. In the middle, here, is all the PDUs switching that are needed for this infrastructure. And on the left and right, you have all the servers. These are very long trays, and in each tray, you have two socket servers. So two servers per tray. So that means that we have this and this. What does it take? It does not take cold water, it takes warm water. Okay, so you do not have to chill your water to run this system. We can take water inlet temperature up to 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, so we only need to have water supply at 35 degrees Celsius. Unlike IBM, which requires deionized water, it's pretty complex to produce deionized water. We can take normal water inside this chassis. Okay? So that's the very high end for people who want to use extremely dense system which have issues of having large requirements. I understand that this might not apply to Ukraine immediately. Vladimir told me yesterday that one of those racks was installed in Ukraine, it would be the equivalent of the largest HPC system that you have in Ukraine currently. Right? So one rack would be the equivalent of your biggest HPC system in Ukraine. Right? So that's roughly the scale at which we are working. So our largest customer for the time being is in the US and is running 8 of those racks. And we have currently a project in Europe with an education institution to install as much as 30 racks of that type. Okay, so this is to give you the scale at which we are working. Now this is direct liquid cooling up to the edge of the server. What we can say also is that this supports up to 80 kilowatts per rack. Currently, a typical rack is what? It's 10-15 kilowatts. At max, with a little bit of effort, you can support 30 kilowatts per rack. This is 80 kilowatts per rack. Okay? And so we have everything pre-integrated, obviously. So we have all the fabrics. So we have InfiniBand, Ethernet, management. We obviously have the full power. We have battery backup. And so it's really impressive. I can tell you our customers really see the difference here about specific design. So again, HP is innovating we know that our customers are demanding this type of products. Now let's move to the pods or performance optimized data center. So this is something which we are selling mostly to countries which have issues with data centers. Okay? So whenever the data center is too old, too difficult to renovate, or whether you have to build a new data center, this is a perfect solution. Because this is, very simply said, a data center in a box. It is a containerized solution. What we do is that we build the container, we take it to our factory after that, and we pre-integrate your IT, whether it be HP or any other vendor, it does not matter. After that, we put it on a truck, deliver it to your site, crane it, put it on your ground, and normally, if everything, we have support teams which are able to do the service around that. The last example which I have, this is being used by one of our very large customers, whose name is Airbus. Probably all of you are familiar with Airbus. So Airbus is having all their HPC systems in pods. Okay, now we'll come back on that a little bit later. That's just to explain to you that they did not want to build the data center, and they are using this as a support for pods. So I know that there are projects in Ukraine currently. We just have recently sold a very large project to a neighboring country in Kazakhstan. That's simply to avoid the cost is so much to build an infrastructure, a data center, that it's more simple to bring in those solutions. So we have various models of pods, obviously. So we have hybrid pods that are valid for performance, HPC with SL and blades, and that's also being used by service providers. Or we have the traditional pods that are being used. But again, now we come back on different models, just to let you know about the philosophy. The philosophy is to make sure that you receive from HP something which is equivalent to a data center. And we can have tier 2 or even tier 3 data center certification for this part. This is also part of the data center complexities, is that the more we go, the more we see that we have requirements to cool racks which are extremely dense. So I'm not talking about Apollo, I'm talking about normal racks. This is the solution that we are using, which are side doors, which are liquid cooled. And that allows you to cool down up to 50 kilowatts per rack. Okay? And that's something that we provide, and that's an HP design that we are providing. So many of our customers are using this system for their cooling solutions in the data center. It is scalable, it is very simple to put in place. Now, I've covered products. So we've seen the storage products, we've seen the server products, we've seen the low power computing products, and we've seen the pods. All of that would be nothing if we did not have the capability to integrate and integrate the pods. So what we do, I was starting my talk by saying that we deliver many systems. I'm just asking you, how many HPC systems did HP deliver in EMEA this year? How many? Just have a guess. Tell me, how many systems could you have delivered? 50? 100? 200? 1,000? The reality is that we have delivered 300 systems this year. Okay, and we are only in October. So 300 systems just requires that you have a production engine. You need to be reliable. You need to have the factory capability to integrate, because each and every system requires hardware, software, tuning, InfiniBand, file system. All those components need to be put together. So you cannot produce 350 systems without a proper